style. Just forget about life for a while. See the world, through our eyes. On the picture perfect skies. It just makes me wanna, hey, let's get away from your mind. Just once in a while, I wanna, hey, just come away with a smile.
The Adventures of Mark and Brian will be right back. Of Mark and Brian.
Hi, Mark and Brian here. This week, we are on a high seas search and rescue mission with the U.S. Coast Guard.
That's because we're very nautical kind of guys.
Ramming speed!
When you think high seas adventure, you think Coast Guard. Rescuing boaters in bad weather and stormy seas. But the first thing we learned about the Coast Guard was, we knew very little about the Coast Guard.
Aside from search and rescue, the Coast Guard is responsible for drug enforcement, environmental protection, buoy tending, marine safety, fishing regulation enforcement, and during wartime, they go into battle with the rest of the armed forces.
The Coast Guard insisted that their motto become our motto, Semper Paratus, always ready.
Which meant that for the next week, we were assured of being always tired. To train us for our helicopter search and rescue, the Coast Guard assigned us to avionics technician Petty Officer Rachel Stacy and rescue swimmer Petty Officer Steve Duhamel. All
right. You go in the water, there's going to be nobody out there to save you. You two are going to be in the water. There's not going to be anybody else around. It's going to be up to you to get that person in the helo, get yourselves back in the helo, and get back safely. Rub it around inside. This
I
will keep,
really hate this part.
This will keep your mask from fogging up.
Of course it will.
Okay? Lloyd Bridges did this. All right, gentlemen, if you'll watch from the side of the pool, I'll demonstrate. We're going to demonstrate the proper technique for entering the water from the helicopter.
Turn toward the camera right now, if you would. Just turn. You're a good-looking man with that on your head.
You air.
He's going to make it rough on us.
He like it.
Yeah, I don't think he does. It ain't going good.
But you know what? If I was him, what? I wouldn't either.
Using Petty Officer Rachel as a victim, it was time to practice jumping out of a helicopter and rescuing a drowning swimmer.
Then, rescue swimmer Steve drilled us on the hand signals used to communicate to the helicopter.
Hit her. All right, what are you calling for? What do you want?
By the way, an important thing to remember when signaling, don't let go of the victim.
There you go. Excellent.
We were feeling pretty darn confident about our newfound rescue ability. So we went off on our own to practice saving others in distress.
You think?
So they're okay.
You think?
It'll make sure they're healthy.
You figure? You're a giver, man.
Yeah.
That's what you are.
Brian's overzealous rescue idea only got us into trouble. But Brian was determined to rescue these ladies, although I think they were doing the rescuing here.
Next, we headed up to San Francisco to resume our training at Coast Guard Island. Rachel and Steve made it clear to us that before we'd be allowed on a helicopter, we'd have to learn what it meant to be a real Coastie and go through every phase of the Coast Guard experience.
The Coast Guard doesn't just come to the rescue of boaters on the water. It comes to the rescue of the water itself by enforcing U.S. fishing regulations and international treaties.
And they wage war against illegal drift and gill net.
Our job was to perform a routine boat inspection.
And that's where Ben Hur used to go, where he'd row boats and everything.
Charlton!
And to learn to identify different species of fish.
Yeah, I'll just
in other
be over
parts
here
of the world,
for just
like
a few.
These are eels.
I think it's
right?
pretty good.
You lower them down and then like let them float, and then I guess you pull.
Hey, Brian,
I ain't coming over there.
Now come here and take a look. It's an eel and he's dead. See? He's not moving around.
He's not doing anything.
Let me just give you a close-up view.
Mark, I'm serious.
Let me just show it to you.
I'm very serious.
I just wanted you to... All right, look, touch it with your finger. Brian?
I'm taking off the net.
Look down here. Hey, Brian?
What?
You should have seen those feet move, man. It moved quickly.
Look, I'm not proud that I'm afraid of snakes.
It's not a snake. That's a fish.
Looks like
a
fish.
It's a fish.
It's a fish. Well, it's long like a snake.
Okay, go ahead and place your hands on top of your head and interlace your fingers. On top of
a large part of the Coastie's mission is drug enforcement. The Coast Guard is allowed to board any ships in U.S. waters or on the high seas, and will frequently confront drug runners and smugglers.
Now, what would happen if you're doing this, if I just went like this and pulled you over like that?
That's where we are prepared. You never make an encounter with an individual without having at least a three-step plan ahead of you.
Okay.
I move in, realizing that you may elect to do this, and then I would simply disengage and start giving further commands and consequences.
I think he disengaged, Brian.
I think it worked.
Sometimes suspects can get belligerent, and self-defense becomes necessary.
Now, how does this baton come out? I was playing with it a second ago. I can't even get it out now.
It's basically, it's locked in by a little spring here. What you really have to do is just give it a firm snap of the wrist and lock it in. There's two different techniques
we teach fighting.
We teach slow stick fighting and we teach extended mode.
How do you get it back in?
Actually, you need a hard surface to close it on. So if you're on a T-clip desk, you would probably just...
I like the fact that you... Yeah, okay, cool. That was great.
You be the bad guy, and you be the coaster.
Okay.
Right. So when you're ready, get
him. I'm the bad guy?
You're the bad guy.
Hit my hand. Rock and sock and robot.
About this time, the Coast Guard thought it best that we move on. So we headed out into the harbor to pull over an unsuspecting boater and conduct a routine safety check on the vessel. We had no idea what was about to happen.
Here to check the status of the boat.
What?
Make sure you're in compliance with the law.
This
is a standard check.
We met with unexpected resistance.
This ain't no down normal Coast Guard board. I've been boarded before. What is this earrings and crap? Get that thing out of my chest.
Skipper, the legitimate Coast Guard's aboard. If television camera bothers you, we can take the cameras off.
Who's the real Coast Guard?
Right here, Chief Oldeman.
United States Coast Guard.
Well, what do you guys continue on our business.
What do you guys need to do?
We're going to do our standard boarding check, see if you're in compliance with all applicable federal laws.
You're going to do the same stuff that you guys done before. That's fine with me.
That's right, Skipper.
I've never been boarded this way before, and...
We understand. It's pretty weird.
A lot of gear folks down below. One of my two guys will show you where it is.
We're going to follow me down. We're going to go ahead to the main salon.
I don't think he was pleased.
Let me know if...
That's got an earring problem.
We went into the main cabin and performed a routine inspection of the boat's safety equipment. All seemed to be in order.
Life jackets. We got some life jackets. Go ahead and pop that open. Get out! Hold on. Okay, you guys back up. I want you guys back up. Back up. Hold still. Be calm. What's your name? All right. You do exactly what I tell you to do. You got it? You understand me?
Yeah.
You guys remember what we showed you on the frisk search? I'm not going to cuff him.
You're not going to cuff him?
Stay off on either side and frisk his legs. I'm going to get his top part.
He's clean.
What started out as very routine suddenly became very intense. Further inspection of the boat revealed a suspicious package.
Can I look in this?
Inside was a substance which tested positive as hashish.
We got nothing but hash here. Look at this.
I think we may know why our young gentleman might have scooted on us.
We helped the Coast Guard place the boat owners into custody. We'd survived our first drug bust.
Well, sort of.
Mark and Brian, I'd like to introduce you to...
I knew it! And you got cut coming out. Your face, you got smacked right there.
Yeah.
You're with the Coast Guard, right?
Yeah, they're both instructors. They both work at up at Petaluma. They're law enforcement instructors.
You scared the hell out of us. Holy cow.
Don't touch that remote. We're coming right back.
Of Mark and Brian.
If someone asks you what's the hardest job you can think of, we've got the answer. buoy tending. We never stop to think about it, but who takes care of all those massive marker buoys you pass by on your boat? The Coast Guard.
And of course, Mark and Brian.
Deadline! Hut!
Holy, how much that weigh?
12,700 pounds, according to the guys who make it.
What, you needed a crane to get this out?
Come on, man.
All we wanted to do was hop in a helicopter, save somebody in the ocean, and go home. Nobody mentioned barnacles.
Now,
last one on top gets to get up the middle of the tube. You ready?
The last one on top?
Last one on top. Go! Come on, get your hand. One, get your other hand out there, go. I think you're it.
I don't think so.
How many people on this buoy deck have been tubing?
Tubing?
Tubing, you're it!
Oh, God, it stinks.
Wait till you get it done. It's great.
Oh, God.
What is that? It looks like oyster Duke. And look, the oysters are alive. See, watch it move. Look at it move.
You know, we started this out, the Swedish bikini team.
I remember that.
I was thinking, this is going to be a good show.
Yeah, but now, we got our heads shoved in a thing that smells like a rotten whale.
We felt that if Rachel, Steve, and the Coast Guard were going to make us clean buoys, then we were going to do it our way.
Appreciate it. No problem.
We didn't do too bad.
The next phase of our training took us to the Coast Guard Pacific Strike Team, an environmental task force who are ready to fly anywhere in the world to help clean up oil spills and chemical contamination.
I'd like to turn you into hazardous material responders today. What do you say about that?
Hazardous material responders.
That's right.
What happens?
Well, you get to put on some funny suits and breathing apparatuses and go into atmospheres of really toxic chemicals.
Are we going to do that today?
We're going to do a little bit of that today.
Go into an atmosphere with really toxic chemicals?
Sure.
Don't we have water polo at 4?
Thought we had another
a little
thing.
Later on.
Yeah.
Next, we suited up in the hazardous material suit, which is not such an easy task. You begin with an inner protective garment, followed by two pairs of gloves, each taped and sealed to the inner garment.
Oompa, oompa, zippity-doo, I've got another riddle for you.
Next comes your self-contained breathing apparatus, complete with full face mask. Then, your voice-activated communication system. Then your helmet. Finally, you step inside the neoprene outer garment, complete with boots and a third pair of gloves. Once you're inside, you're completely protected from any hazardous chemicals and gases. You become a human seal, Emil.
Ladies and gentlemen, we give you sex in the 90s.
The Coast Guard has a special way of getting you acclimated to the rigors of wearing the hazardous material suit. It's designed to test your stamina during extended periods of grueling environmental protection work. It's called volleyball. Just catching the ball seemed impossible, let alone finding it.
You know what one of the main problems with these are? You have to smell your own breath.
Rachel and Steve told us that if we wanted to become true search and rescue experts, we were going to have to train on the Coast Guard's workhorse rescue vessel, the 44-foot motor lifeboat. Virtually unsinkable, it's the M1 tank of the Coast Guard fleet.
This is how my dad taught me to swim.
Man overboard, starboard!
The Coast Guard trains for man overboard rescues with a dummy they affectionately refer to as Oscar. The object is to retrieve Oscar from the water quickly and efficiently, not two of our better attributes.
Here it comes. And slow down! Did you get it?
I'm thinking it could be me, but a little slower. Yeah.
By this time, the Coast Guard felt that we truly didn't appreciate the importance of getting a victim out of the water as soon as possible.
Hurry.
Yeah,
do it.
They have a cure for that.
Come on.
Oh. Wait a minute.
Guys, come out of this water.
All right, we just got a small taste of what it would feel like to be stranded.
Or thrown off a boat or fall off a boat by accident.
The whales go, you know, 10 feet above your head, you can't see anything, and it's freezing.
And you can't breathe, because every time you take a breath, the swell of water will throw over, and you get water in your mouth. It was frightening. It was scary.
It was the day before our search and rescue mission. Rachel and Steve wanted us to relax their way. We finally got a chance to sit down and talk with our Coast Guard guides, Rachel and Steve, and ask about how it feels to be on a high seas search and rescue.
Have you ever actually done, for real, what we're going to do tomorrow?
Yeah. It was the case of two surfers were stranded, and they got caught in a cove, and they couldn't get out. The waves were breaking.
How did you find out about them? They didn't have a flare.
One of their buddies got out, and called the Coast Guard, and then they called the fire department, and everybody was on scene. It was similar to like a television experience where a million people are watching you do this, mm-hmm. and you want to look good, and you want to perform mm-hmm. and do well for these people,
and save
get
lives.
These people's lives out.
Yeah, this life saving thing. Remember that?
You want to look good. Yeah, you really do.
U.S. Coast Guard Air Station, San Francisco. This is emergency line. How may I help you?
This is Coast Guard Station San Francisco. We have a report of a boat fire near the Bay Bridge. Boat disabled, two persons in the water. One 41-footer, an RHIB underway. ETA 35 minutes. Request helicopter with rescue swimmers.
NASA Radio, you on the line. Boat on fire off River Buena Island.
All right, go! Get your gear cut, bud. Go. Going? Yeah, let's go.
Grab your gear.
It was rescue time. We'd been fish police. We'd piloted the 44-foot motor lifeboat. We'd worn hazardous chemical suits. We'd fought drug smugglers.
And let's not forget, we cleaned buoys.
We'd taken everything the Coast Guard could dish out. Now it was time to head out on a search and rescue training mission with us doing the rescuing.
Roger. Current time is minute 4-8. I say again, minute 4-8.
Chico Pond, first attack. Ready to taxi. Park break.
The scenario was dangerous. A burning boat was stranded in the middle of San Francisco Bay. Two people had jumped overboard, and it was our job to rescue them.
Coast Guard copter 142. We are airborne. 11 COP. We are en route to Yerba Buena Island.
Okay, Martin Brent, this area in here is where we're going to be deploying you from the aircraft. This is a heavily trafficked area. It's right underneath the bridge here. So you are going to need to keep a keen eye out for debris, sea creatures, that kind of thing. There's a lot of activity in these waters right here. Once you're in the water, keep good eye contact with the aircraft, okay? Okay, good luck.
Okay, looks like we've got two people in the water and a boat on fire.
Our mission would be to jump 20 feet from a hovering helicopter into the frigid waters of the bay and get each of the victims into a basket hoist so they could be lifted to safety.
Roger, I got to take this inside. Swimmers coming forward.
6'12" and 80 mile an hour proc wash. We managed to grab the victim and signal the helicopter.
Deploy basket signal. Roger. Deploy right. Being deployed right. Hold. In the water, surfers are attempting to bring survivors to the basket. Survivors in the basket.
Having rescued the victim, we were lifted back into the helicopter in a device called the double fleeing aviator hoist.
Roger. They have hookup. Swimmers are preparing to take the load.
The aviator hoist is the most uncomfortable contraption known to man, which is why we think Rachel and Steve suggested we use it.
Swimmers are still coming up. Swimmers are outside the cabin. Swimmers are inside the cabin. Hook off. Going off
hotline.
Great job.
How
are you guys doing?
Holy cow. First of all,
great
that water
job.
Is cold.
Great job. Outstanding.
Well, you guys are a little rescue swimmers now.
I hear you.
We're ready for board flight.
I said, I'm not sure who saved who down there. I think the victims might have saved us. We have never had quite an experience like that, because to jump in a freezing ocean and actually partake in saving someone's life is something that you can't imagine what it feels like. You guys okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah, thanks.
And thanks for your help. All right, listen. Thank you for joining this week's Adventures of Mark and Brian. Good night, and thanks to Rachel, Steve, and the U.S. Coast Guard. They're out here being heroes every day.
We thought we'd take a break here,
so you can watch some commercials.
Hey, mate, we'll find traps. These are dungeonettes.
These are what?
Dungeonette traps. It's just a type.
Oh, a dungeonette.
Hey, he's alive.
Yeah. Is he really?
Okay. Hey, oh, look, what? Look, look, all the stuff moving.
I see nothing moving.
What?
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Did he try to snatch it? I opened that up and pinched it right back. I'm not having a good fish day today.